all people come to him, come to the way, O Sultan Rabbiya, most honored one and most glorified one, most praised one, in divine presence, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I wish, and all of you, you wish, of course, to be under the feet of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Every wali, every scholar, every human being wish to be under the feet of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. مدد يا سيدي يا رسول الله يا رحمة للعالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. I just arrived from London yesterday and today I am here with this stormy and negative temperature, -15, -20 Fahrenheit, which made this event to be delayed a little bit. May Allah bless the organizers and bless you all. I'm not going to be too long. I will be very short, and I want to say that this is a night of a joy night, joyful night, happy night to celebrate and to observe the birth of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the birth of Islam. The most important community today and in our society and in Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah is to strengthen the belief and to believe more about our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and understand, as Dr. In'am al-Haq just now expressed, Rahmatan lil Alameen. It was very nicely done and I appreciate that. May Allah bless you to give us more. I will add one thing, is that Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, Allah has sent him to Khidr alayhi salam to understand the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he mentioned in Holy Quran, فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. Where Allah says in Holy Quran that Sayyidina Musa and his helper, Sayyidina Yusha, they found one servant of Allah's servants. One servant of many. Means there are many like Sayyidina Al-Khidr in their knowledge. And those are awliya Allah. Sayyidina Musa found one. And Ummat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will find another for everyone one. So when he found that one, what he described, فَوَجَدَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا, a servant of ours. أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. First of all, we established him. We strengthened his belief in رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. By this way, we opened for him our knowledge. So, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, since he is rahmatan lil alameen, in this verse particularly, أَتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا علمناه من لدن علم. Before he taught him Allah from heavenly knowledge, he addressed him from رحمة العالمين, from رحمة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So means علوم سيدنا الخضر, the knowledge of سيدنا الخضر are coming from the fountain of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Like محي الدين ابن عربي, he said, my hand saved the boat of Nuh عليه السلام. If my hand was not under the boat or the vessel of Nuh عليه السلام, that boat would have sank. But my hand saved the boat. And it was, they asked how, and he said that I am part of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. I am from Nasr al-Sharif, from his inheritors. I am from him. My blood is from him. So my hand means that small hand was put together with the hand of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم under the boat, and the boat was saved. So I saved the boat. So anything is done to bring the name of Prophet high, you'll be rewarded for it. And what kind of reward in this evening is that this majlis, this association tonight, is a garden of heaven. There are gardens of heaven on earth. Rawda, there are Riyadh. Too many. When Prophet ﷺ said to Sahaba, do you like to be in gardens of heaven? Of course, everyone wants to be sitting in a garden of heaven. And Prophet ﷺ described it and said, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. When you pass it by the garden of heaven, sit there. You are in this place, in this moment, that place is termed the garden of heaven. And this is because Prophet ﷺ indicated it in the hadith, in his hadith, that is to Sahaba from that time. If you pass by gardens of heaven, sit. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, they said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, what are the gardens of heaven on earth? We know one garden of heaven, is the Rawda Sharifa, Riyadh al-Jannah, is the Rawda, that area that been blessed by heavens, heavenly nur on it. That is the Rawda, that everyone, every Hajj can go there and pray there. He said, answering the Sahaba, when I asked him, وَمَا رِيَاضُ الْجَنَّةِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, what are the garden of heaven? He said, حِلَقُ الزِّكْرِ, the circles of zikr. And tonight this is a circle of zikrullah. Remembrance of Allah, remembrance of Prophet, remembrance of Islam. So it is it's becoming a garden of heaven, means the manifestation of the beauty of the garden of heavens is being dressed tonight on everyone that is here. This is not my speech. This is what Prophet ﷺ has indicated in that hadith. So be happy, and you are going to be happy dunya and akhirah. Prophet ﷺ said, because every one of us want to save himself from shaitan and from anything. He said, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. I'm giving you something very easy for ladies and for men, for Allah to forgive you. Two words, كلمتان, two words, خفيفتان على اللسان, they are very light on the tongue, ثقيلتان في الميزان, very heavy in the scale. Mizan. If you recite them every day, even one time, they are going to make your mizan, your scale in the day of judgment, heavy with hasanat of rewards, and make your sayyad very light. Prophet ﷺ has showed his rahmah, where he said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. The whole Islam, he said, I have been sent to perfect your manners, your characters, your behaviors. So if we, Prophet is take on his responsibility that he is going to perfect our manners and behaviors. Because he said, إنما بعثت for sure I have been sent لأتمم مكارم الأخلاق to complete and to perfect the, your manners and your behavior. So we are laying our back on Prophet now, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he will save us in the day of judgment from everything that we have done, because he has, Allah will give him the shafa'ah to Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam. There are many things that we can touch on, but I would like to touch on one small issue, and but it is huge and the reward, and the reward of in Allah's reward is the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, where it begins Alif Lam Mim. Alif is a one letter, Lam is one letter, and Mim is one letter. Alif is indicating the first letter of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always Alif is standing. Lam is, as scholars they say, and awliya Allah, is Jibreel alayhi salam. From Allah to Jibreel to the Mim. Mim is Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam. But that Mim is consisting of two memes. When we say Mim, Alif, Lam, Mim, when we say Mim, it's two memes. Mim, Ma, Ya, and Ma. Three of them, two of them. Between them there is Ya, there is an ocean there. So first Mim is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the reality that Allah created first in heaven. The second Mim is the reality of Muhammad that receiving the wahi from Jibreel alayhi salam on earth. So he has two personalities, one with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one with the creation. And he is encompassing everything through that, by Allah's order. So our Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam, what Allah gave to him, he did not give to anyone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep giving him, and Prophet will give his ummah. Because when he was born, he was asking, ummati, ummati. When he is in bed, sick in bed, he was asking, ummati, ummati. In day of judgment, he will be asking, ummati, ummati. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us under his feet and keep us with his blessings to be good people and peaceful people. Wa min Allah al-tawfiq. Wa assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Takbir! Allahu Akbar!